Hi, I'm John Hartley, salesperson here with the RV Corral. Today I'm going to show you a 2017 Sunseeker 3010 floor plan. This one has full body paint and it has the theater seating. That's really a neat option to get in it. So the Sunseeker has a lot of value for the money in a Class C. It's a fiberglass roof on top. It's got the fiberglass front cap. It's got rock protection material up here on the front of the hood of it. It is a double slide unit. It's about 32 feet in actual length. Nice big running boards on it. Your generator's here. It's a 4,000 watt Onan generator. This right here is your side view cameras. These are a wide angle lens. Comes up on the stereo in the dash. Does have, of course, a rear view camera. Full body paint, nice, what, three colors in it. There's storage underneath that. But back here is your, where your dump station area is. They come with a sewer hose. They've come out with a new design here. Kind of attaches like a fire hose does on it. But they're providing that with the units. Fuel right here, outside shower. Shore cord is a detachable shore cord, so open this up. The shore cord just goes on easily. Your TV cable and black tank flush. City water connection. Then you've got a lot of storage. It's a full pass-through compartment, and they do put a drain in them here so that if you ever need to wash this out, you can open the drain and rinse it out. There's LED lighting in here. Little push button in the middle of the light. So being a fiberglass roof, it's a full walk-on roof. You got a ladder to get up on top. There's your backup camera back here, which it's a wide angle lens, so it does give you a good view down the road when you're traveling. Over here, this one comes with a barbecue. This is its stand, and underneath it is a table that removes for setting up your barbecue and barbecuing out there. You don't need to carry propane for that barbecue because it connects up to the RV. There's a port on the RV to connect to its propane tank. Storage compartment and then filtered water inside. And then these all come with their Firestone Ride-Rite airbags on them to help them handle the weight. And these can tow 7,500 pounds above full payload on these. So these are able to tow a lot of things that even some of the Class A's can't tow. So this is the back of the refrigerator. This one does have the big fridge in it. The furnace. And this is where your... Ah, there it is. The propane connection for the barbecue is. So you got a nice power awning on it, your propane tank, more storage here, and these are pretty neat. They put the garbage can where you empty it from outside, and there's a hole in the countertop that we'll see in a minute for getting in there to empty or to put garbage in. So again, LED light strip on the power awning here. Speakers in the awning, so your stereo inside can play through those or inside. These have, come around here, let me show them this. So right here you've got your automatic leveling system. It's a Bigfoot leveling system, easy to operate from just standing outside the RV. This is a main power cutoff, so when you flip that off when you're leaving the RV, all the lights go out, it shuts off everything. And then your awning control is here, and then outside lights and porch light under there. So now we're inside, and this is the theater seating. I love this option in these because it does have seat belts, and you've got your TV straight across from you. Pull the lever and sit back. You got your cup holder here. Kids could ride here with the seat belt on and playing games or movies up there. And what's really neat with the Sunseeker, as you notice, we're not hooked to power right now, we're just got the batteries turned on, but we have power to this TV right now because it's a 12 volt operated TV. Don't have to run an inverter, don't have to run the generator, don't have to be plugged in for the TV to work. So going down the highway, kids could watch a movie there, And they didn't waste any space because the TV becomes the cupboard door. So you've got storage behind it. You use it for kitchen storage or TVs and video, or you know, video things like that that you may want. Lots of counter space in this model. And there's where the garbage can is. So that way the dog doesn't knock it over, and just makes for a lot nicer RVing trip. Lots of drawers, all wood, full metal glides on it all the way, you know, pulls all the way out. Positive latches, so you don't have to lift up on them. But you got lots of drawers. Got some cupboard space here. A deeper cupboard space here under the sink. More drawer space. Over here, it's got the circular dinette. I like how the circular dinette, you've got this, you can release the knob there, swivel that to get in and out of the back of the dinette easier. This will go down to make a bed. Or if you need more cooking space and you already got a lot of counter space, swivel it around this way and you've got more right across from your oven and microwave. LED lighting up over the top, push button just like that one out in the bay. This one was ordered with the big refrigerator, and it is an RV refrigerator, and it has an ice maker built into it. So you've got the big RV fridge, and that's one thing. You know, you can always find places to store dry food, but refrigerator, you know, that's all you got for fridge space. All your controls are right here. Start the gen from here. Read your tank levels. These have an Arctic package on them. It's 12 volt heaters on the tank so they don't freeze. You've got living room and kitchen light switches here. Water heater controls, slide room controls for the two slide rooms on it. We'll go through into the bedroom and then we'll come back to the bathroom. So queen size bed, nice thick, you know, nice mattress. It's a Serta mattress in there. You've got a little bit of storage underneath. Not much, but put a few blankets and things there. This is part of the slide, so when this closes up, it closes up again, you know, just under the edge of here, but it's still usable as a bed. And you've got lots of closet space because you got closet here with a light that comes on automatically. Cupboard space between, and then they didn't waste the space behind the TV again. And 12 volt TV, and then more closet space here. And what, four drawers underneath. So, bathroom. You got a porcelain toilet. Nice bathroom separated with the hallway from the shower. That door, push it all the way open. And it latches magnetically open. And then your shower's on this side. And decent sized shower. You know, this is a little 32-foot Class C, lots of headroom here. I'm not a great judge of that because I'm not very tall, but you can see there's a skylight there. And just really nicely appointed, lots of nice features to it. The air is ducted throughout the whole thing. I think this one has a heat pump on it too, so you got electric heat and propane heat. They do things like, you know, if you don't like this pattern on this, this is reversible. You can flip it over. And it's an actual comforter, not a mattress cover like so many other RVs just provide. Let's go back out in the living room. The flooring, it's a vinyl floor, looks like a wood plank. Works really nice. It's a Belfour floor. It's scratch resistant, weather resistant. It prevents moisture from ever getting to the wood underneath it. You've got a cab over bed up here. Ladder detaches from here. This slips into place like that. This is a child guard here. It latches up on each side over here and here so that small children don't roll out of bed. This one does have driver and passenger swiveling seats. Backup camera here is in your stereo. It links to your phone for GPS. It's the Ford V10 with a 6-speed automatic in it. Like I said, it can tow 7,500 pounds above its 14,500-pound GVW. So this can tow more weight than a lot of your smaller Class A's. Those are pretty much limited to 5,000 pounds above the GVW for most of your smaller Class A's. You got driver passenger doors with power windows. Really nicely appointed. Great value in a Class C. And this is just one of many Sunseekers we have. If you don't like this floor plan, we've got other floor plans. Lots of them in stock right now. So my name is John Hartley. One of the best ways to reach me is by my cell phone. That's 541-953-5420. Or you can email me at johnh@rvcorral.com. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video.